Hello, welcome to the Friday, December 3rd, 2021 edition of the Sands and its Storm Centers Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich, and today I'm recording from Jacksonville, Florida. Brad took a look at the latest campaign using password-protected zip files. They're arriving via email once the user extracts the file, enables macros, and runs the HTA file. They will now be infected with Iced ID or BokBot. This campaign is part of what Brad describes as TA551, also known as ShadHack. It's essentially a malicious spam group that does distribute whatever malware comes around. So have seen this quite a few times before, pushing various malware. There is also a possible follow-up with Cobalt Strike if the infected system is part of an Active Directory domain. That's, of course, something that has become the norm now, where an attacker will sort of install commodity malware if it's not a system that's part of Active Directory. If it is part of Active Directory, then, of course, the assumption is that it's maybe a higher value organization, so it may be worthwhile taking a second look. And then by installing Cobalt Strike, the attacker often then proceeds with ransomware. And for the Python developers out there, a neat little package, pip audit. You just install it with pip itself, and it installs a little command line tool that, if you just run it by itself, will check your installed Python packages for anyone that are vulnerable. Just ran it myself on my desktop, and it found three vulnerable packages that I had installed. Of course, a quick upgrade did mitigate this problem. All in all, only took maybe 5 minutes, so certainly worth your time to give it a little try, and maybe can even be scheduled as a cron job or so to continuously alert you if any of your packages should have vulnerabilities. It uses the Python packaging advisory database, which is available via GitHub. So just a simple request to the JSON data offered by this database will then be compared to the packages you have installed. And well, it's that day of the week again, like any day of the week where we have more vulnerabilities in routers. A group that calls itself IoT Inspector, together with the German IT magazine Chip, did test a number of different routers, ran into 226 potential security vulnerabilities. And this is not just one vendor. This is Asus, AVM, D-Link, Netgear, Edimax, TP-Link, Synology, and Linksys. Probably the saddest part of this is not just the sheer number of vulnerabilities, but also the type of vulnerabilities they found. They didn't really do any super advanced penetration test. A lot of it is just out-of-date components installed in the firmware of these devices, default passwords, and then also hard-coded passwords and keys that are the same across all of the devices from a particular manufacturer. Well, and talking about hacking, we do have the Sands Holiday Hack Challenge coming up. And with me today, I have Ed Skotis to tell me a little bit about this challenge and how to participate. Ed, tell us about the story, like what's going on this year at the North Pole. Apparently, all the effort spent with Jack Frost and so last year didn't quite work out.
Well, it happens every year. You know, some nefarious supervillain tries to destroy the whole holiday season. And thankfully, we have, you know, cybersecurity professionals from around the world who kind of help Santa Claus and the elves to set things straight. And yeah, it's happening again this year. Now, if you've never played in the past, that's okay. You can jump right in and get into the story fresh. But that said, if you played last year, you'll see a familiar character who's come back. Last year, Jack Frost tried to destroy the holiday season, and our players helped put him in his place and try to bring him to justice. But you know, at the North Pole, the wheels of justice grind very slowly. It's super complex, and Jack Frost got off on a technicality. So this year's subtitle, Sans Holiday Hack Challenge, is called Jack's Back. So Jack Frost has a whole new plan to destroy the holiday season, and we need help.
So it's not that Jack got out on bail and we have to like get him back in.
No.
He just totally got off.
It's a complicated thing. I mean, I'm not a legal expert on the North Pole's legal structure, but I do know that he is back, and wait till you see him. He's got a kind of a new look to him. He's got helpers. He's bought up a bunch of land around Santa's castle and has embarked on this grand construction project. But that said, you know, that's our storyline. The challenges themselves this year are phenomenal. I think they're some of the best challenges we've ever created. And, you know, we have a virtual world. Some people don't even know what Holiday Hack Challenge is. What is it? Well, fundamentally, it's a North Pole themed cyber range, right? You could think of it as a CTF, but it's a CTF +++. So there's all these great challenges for you to solve. But you solve them by interacting with a virtual world where you can see other players and you can collaborate and work with them. There's non-player characters in there of Santa and the elves, and they give you hints. We try to make it fun. We try to make it social. There's a Discord server, so you can go in there and have chats in various channels. It's all that kind of stuff. But really, the centerpiece of it is the challenges. And one of the things that we're doing with the challenges is, as you walk around the North Pole, you can gather tech gear, various elements of tech gear, and use that to do some of your hacking challenges. I'll give you an example from last year. Last year, that's not this year. This year, we got a whole new set of technologies for you. But last year, as you walked around, you were able to pick up a little Proxmark device, you know, for writing to HID cards, and reading HID cards. So you were able to skim the proximity cards from some of the elves and then use those to get into other areas within the Santa castle at the North Pole. So the idea is, you know, we've got this virtual world where we're showing you how you could do physical attacks in this world and teaching you technologies that you might not know about. I mean, have you ever used a Proxmark to skim HID cards and then actually used one to clone HID cards? Well, in Holiday Hack 2020 last year's, you could. And this year we have a whole set of new technologies that maybe you haven't played with yet that you want to learn as a cybersecurity professional. I mean, there's traditional challenges in there. There's things of attacking Windows and attacking Linux and defending Linux and defending Windows. But we also try to kind of push the envelope on things that maybe you've never seen before in a CTF, but it's useful for you as a cybersecurity practitioner to understand these kinds of attacks and the kinds of defenses associated with them. We're constantly trying to think of new stuff that people have never seen before. But by learning it, it'll make them better at their jobs. It's Johannes, you know this. This is Sans promise. This is the Sans promise.
And you know, I hear it from people who have taken part in it and how excited they are, how they like, you know, didn't really get much done in December in their day job because they...
But they saved the holiday season.
That's so much. And you know, you have to get your priorities straight. You know, if Jack Frost's on the loose and... Or your company is getting infected with ransomware, you really have to figure out what's happening. Now,
you could do both.
I guess you could do both. And you hopefully get better at defending in your day job as you are playing those challenges.
And hopefully, based on what you learn in the challenges.
Yeah.
So I think this year is going to be a lot of fun for people. You know, we have a custom soundtrack of music. We're finalizing the music right now. You know, some of our songs from last year were just spectacular. Really, really pleased with how those came out. So the music for Holiday Hack Challenge is on all of the streaming services. So if you go to your favorite streaming service, whatever it happens to be, and do a search for the artist Holiday Hack Challenge, you can listen to all of that. And we've had great musicians in the past, like Ninjala, who will be back this year. Josh Scotus, who's my son, he'll be back this year. If you look at some of the songs in the past, we've had Dual Core. We're not having Dual Core back this year. We usually do a Dual Core song that's a rap group every other year. And then occasionally we'll have other special artists that pop in and do some cool stuff. So I really do hope people will play. We're hoping for a record turnout this year. Just again, this is really Sans' gift to the cybersecurity community. We want to help make the world a safer, more secure place, and we want to do that by providing really compelling and useful free content to the community. And that's what the Sans Holiday Hack Challenge is all about.
Yeah, I know from talking to you what a huge effort it is to really put this together. And I think you can tell by looking at, you know, all the little details that you put in. I think you sort of hinted on on some of those details that that you added here to these challenges.
Oh yeah.
Any tips? Like, I guess it's for beginners and advanced users, it's or
everybody. Yes. Yeah. So if you're brand new to cybersecurity, we've got stuff for you. If you're super advanced, we've got stuff for you. So my biggest tips are this. One is when you look at the challenges, they're in your badge. So you have a little avatar. The badge is the thing in the middle of your avatar. You just click on it. It looks like a gift this year, like a holiday present. So you click on that and then you'll see the objectives. Look at the difficulty of the objectives. Every objective is rated between 1 and 5 Christmas trees of difficulty. 1 Christmas tree is easy, 5 Christmas trees is hard. If you're newer, please start with the 1 Christmas trees and we'll build you up and you'll learn. That's first tip. Look at the difficulty based on number of Christmas trees next to the objective in your batch. Second, click on the elves. The elves are there to give you hints. Now, you might have to help an elf solve some simple technical challenge so they can give you hints for more complex technical challenges. So click on the elves. Third hint is go to our Discord channel. Within the game, there's a little thing you click on and it says click here to go to Discord. And in Discord, we have a lot of players who are there and they chat and they work together as teams. We encourage teams. We encourage, you know, mutual interactions. There's going to be a channel for each different challenge. So if you're stuck on a challenge, you can go in there. But we also have Kringle concierges at KringleCon, that's our conference. And the Kringle concierges are there if you get stuck, not on a technical challenge, but if you get stuck in some sort of game dynamic or something like that, the Kringle concierges can help you move forward. And then the final hint, because I've lost count on which number I'm on, the final hint is watch the KringleCon talks, because many of the talks are there with hints for the challenges. So, and it's pretty clear which ones are. You look at what the challenge is about, and then you go and say, hey, there's a talk here about this thing. So that'll help move you forward as well.
Excellent. So how do people get started? And when, approximately?
So it's going to be starting in the next week or so. We always launch the second week of December. We don't give it a specific date. And the reason for that is sometimes Santa Claus has got to adjust a couple of holiday bulbs and wrap a couple more presents. And also we like to do a soft launch where we put the stuff up, but we don't want, 15,000 people to hit us at exactly the same time. So we kind of ramp up. So we usually turn it on and then we do our official big announce later the second week of December. And people can get there by going to holidayhackchallenge.com. Or this year we've got a new thing, sans.org/holidayhack. So that'll take you there as well. And I think people are really gonna have fun with it. Enjoy the storyline. People ask us, like, where's the leaderboard? We don't really have a leaderboard. And that's on purpose because we want people to just enjoy the challenge itself and have fun with it and learn from it. Is there a competition? Yes, there is. But the competition is really among those people who complete all of the challenges and do a write-up to send it in. And we encourage people to do their write-ups. I mean, that's great. We love to get them. We read through every single one. Last year we had 19,000 players, and we choose the best overall challenge, the grand winner, and they win a SANS class, which is pretty awesome. But we also choose other ones that get access to NetWars and so forth. Some get t-shirts. But of the 19,000 players, we have about 7 or 8 people who win. Because it's more about the learning and the sharing and the community than winning. That said, some people are so motivated by winning, more power to you, but that's how we do it. You could also get a sense of how you're doing by popping into the Discord and talking with other players there and seeing how far they're getting along. We have each channel, challenge 1, challenge 2, challenge 3, gets up to about like 10 or 12 challenges. You can pop into, the channel for challenge 12 and see how people are doing and what they're saying, right? But we really, really do want this to be kind of a community thing.
Excellent. Excellent. So the links will be in the show notes. And thanks for joining me here and hope that people will have as much fun or more than they usually have. Thanks, Ed.
Thanks, Dr. J. Appreciate it.
Well, that's it for today. Thanks again for listening and talk to you again on Monday. Bye.